Now, even though I was actually getting excited about doing my own outfit, this is something that I actually need to finish off first. This is the samosa salwar that we'd cut a couple of days ago before we actually went on to stitch baby Anaya's before this. Now, the salwar that this girl has requested is to be made in black, and we are actually inserting black lace on this. She wants to make it look a little bit more casual, so first thing we're going to do is edge it off and use the black lace to trim off the edges, and this edge acts as a guide of this acts as the whole turning actually, so there's no need to make the ponchas or anything. And all I'm doing is, the fabric has already been cut, the lace is a black sequence lace which you can purchase online from our website, hopefully pretty soon. I think I've run out of the black on black at the moment, but we will get it back in stock. So now the other thing that I will be doing is, hopefully over the summer months, we will be doing a version of these salwars to buy online. And I'm going to source out some nice beautiful fabric that you can combine these and wear them with lots of variation of outfits for all my young and trendy customers. So we're going to do these probably in about 5 colours and probably in about 3 sizes. The size of these does not vary a hell of a lot, because it's only the belt actually, because that's the only part that's it. And we'll be doing some, hopefully some chiffon dresses to go with these, which you can mix and match. And I think the way we're going to do these is probably 3 styles of the salwars that are quite difficult to sew on their own, that you may find a little bit complicated to sew. But you can order the 3 salwars and wear, you know, different, wear these with different outfits. And I think this is something that's going to be very, very huge, popular item over the summer months. I hope we get a nice summer like we have been doing over the last couple of days. What the problem I have while sitting over here is actually my machine is back facing the window, and a little bit of the light from the back of the window actually shines onto the surface of the machine, and sometimes this obstructs the reflection. This reflects in the camera. So I may need to relocate my machine. I have to be very careful because obviously I'm working, and these are machines which I actually use for a lot of the sewing, the general sewing as well. And some of the problems that we actually encounter is that I have to locate the machine in such a place that it's accessible for the camera and easy for me to get to. It's in range with the overlockers, because normally you probably see me swiveling from one to the other. I have a swivel chair, and obviously being driven by a huge workload, I have to try and combine and mix everything together. Now the lace has been inserted on one side of the panel. I am just going to go and get a scissor. Now, during the last summer months, during last year's summer months, one of the things we had in big demand were lots of variations of salwars. And actually, this goes back to the time when I was actually showing the 21 versions of the salwar. Now, one of the things that I am actually in disagreement of, and this was when I did the 21 versions of the Silvar, was that what we have here is I have to make sure that both my pieces are facing exactly opposites. So if I just quickly show you what I mean, this is the cutting of the one side. It's been cut around for the crotch area around here, and I have to make sure that my other piece is absolutely identical to this. So that is the same, but what I have to do is I have to do a continuation. So I just turn it, put them facing each other, and then turn it over so that it's exactly following the other piece. So both the right sides of the embroidery will be the sequins would be facing each other. Now I'm going to do exactly the same, attach the lace onto this, so that first of all both my pieces are absolutely identical and laced over. Now, we were talking about the 20 versions of the Silvar, and at the time when I did the 21 versions of the Silvar, one of the points that I actually didn't like were these were ready-made Silvar that had come onto the market as mass-produced, and with the mass-produced, you could imagine the mass production as that of maybe Primark, but the quality of the stitching, general stitching that our markets have, is worse than Primark. So we were selling these salwars, and initially they started selling at around about £15 per salwar. Then we had them on for 2 for 25, and then they went down to about £10 a salwar, and then they were even selling for less than £10. Now, price wise, they dropped down considerably, but the making was absolutely horrendous. So, you know, the fabrics used were not all that, and that was really an off put. I think what you need is, when you have salwars like this, you need to make sure that they are in nice good fabric that you feel proud to wear, nice good combination of colors, and nicely designed and sewn. And if you have the combination of those three things, then that will actually make you feel proud to wear that item again and again. You will never ever want to dispose of it. It's like the disposable, I call this the disposable clothing, when you go and buy something ready-made, which is tatty fabric, cheap fabric, cheap making, no real design to it, just a put together piece that's just selling for the sake of selling. And I'm in disagreement of that. I like to have classy items with good quality fabric and good quality stitching and nice neat lines, neatly designed. And even if you were to pay £10 more for that, then you value that. You never feel like you ever ever want to throw that away. I know customers who have had stuff stitched by me who value that and treasure that, even though it might go tatty and it might wear out. They value that and keep it in their wardrobes just forever and ever, because it's so nicely sewn that you just don't want to part with it. And we all have that habit, we all have that tendency to do that. Now, the first part of our salwar is completed. I'm going to pause here and come back and show you the next part.